So this is Bill for the National Association of Podcasters and oldgrads.com. I'm training, doing this for both organizations. And the primary reason I'm doing this is for both is one, freedom of speech for the National Association of Podcasters and a little bit of training. So Alec Zeck, who is a West Point grad, had some excellent testimony at the state capitol the last few days. And I just want to show you where his side is. He is a podcaster, has a podcast, but he's really on a lot of other podcasts. He does really well. I'd like to learn more about him. Really like some of his points and his testimony. So we're going to watch his testimony. We're going to also show how he got it out. So what he did here, so he's testifying here. And this is really moving. Now, what he's done, and what I want to show you for freedom of speech concepts and what we've had to do and why we created the National Association Podcast Freedom of Speech podcast, because they weren't blocking it. But YouTube, of course, is taking everything down. But here's two things. One, he's doing public testimony. So if YouTube's going to take something down, this is for the record. It's on public testimony. It's very controversial. And it's, of course, about the coronavirus issues. He's a health and fitness lifestyle coach, I believe, and a very good podcaster, good communicator. So we'll go ahead and watch his video and take some points out. I also want to talk, too, since this is on oldgrads.com, really, this I would love to see the Secretary of Defense, Chairman Joint Chief of Staff, and the Superintendent at West Point watch this video and think about it. Because in the last few days, especially West Point, man, and the military, they are getting pounded for what they're doing to their cadets and soldiers, reference to COVID issues.
Next, we have Daniel Alec Zeck, followed by Christina Hobbiger. Welcome to the committee, Daniel.
My name is Alec Zeck. I'm 29 years old. I'm a Kansas native. I'm a father, a husband, a West Point graduate, and an Army veteran. Most importantly, I'm a human being just like you. I'm asking you to open your heart as a human being and listen to what I have to say. According to the CDC's own data, 95% of COVID deaths had an average of 4 comorbidities, most being lifestyle or nutrition related. 78% of hospitalizations were in overweight or obese people. The largest risk factors for death, again, according to the CDC, are obesity and fear/anxiety related disorders. Given the clear implications of this data straight from the CDC, why have our government health officials kept us in perpetual fear over the last 20 months? Why haven't our government officials and public health experts mentioned anything about mindfulness, lifestyle, and nutrition? A time-sensitive health emergency? No, it's been 20 months. Lack of funding? No. The federal government spent $10 billion with a B, billion dollars to increase confidence for vaccine and improve vaccine infrastructure. If this is about health, why aren't we educating and allocating resources and funding towards things that actually make us healthy? Also, given the implications of the data I shared from the CDC, why are we mandating an experimental product with no long-term safety data made by habitually criminal companies who aren't liable for injury or death when the product doesn't even stop transmission of disease or confer immunity to disease? In fact, a recent peer-reviewed study that looked at 68 countries in 2,947 U.S. counties found that there was, quote, no discernible relationship between percentage of population fully vaccinated and new COVID-19 cases. And in fact, the trend line suggests a marginally positive association such that countries with higher percentage of population fully vaccinated had higher COVID-19 cases per 1 million people. There are now over 800,000 reports filed to the Vaccine Adverse Event Reporting System, including over 17,000 deaths. We keep hearing that, quote, VAERS is unreliable because it's a passive reporting system and anyone can file a report. They leave out the necessary context that it's a federal offense to falsify a VAERS report. If VAERS is, quote, unreliable, and individual stories of vaccine injury are censored, silenced, deleted, and discredited, and they've unblinded the placebo group from the clinical trials so they can't track safety that way, how are the experts effectively tracking safety of these shots? I have one of the top health and fitness podcasts in the United States called Health Freedom for Humanity. We started a new podcast series called Voices of the Victims, where we have been interviewing people who were injured or know someone who was killed by the COVID shot. Two of those people are now having to move out of their homes because they're unable to work since being injured, and they receive no compensation from the companies whose products they received. Meanwhile, a recent Forbes article highlighted that Pfizer is set to make $33.5 billion from vaccines in 2001. Pfizer paid the largest criminal fine in U.S. history with $2.3 billion for mispromoting medicines and paying kickback to compliant doctors. Pfizer has on multiple occasions lied, bribed doctors, mispromoted medicines, withheld data, knowingly caused harm, and used unwitting children in Africa as guinea pigs. Given all that I've shared, and this is just a fraction of what I could have, how is mandating this product as a condition to participate in society even on the table? Everyone has a right to choose what is best for their own health without coercion or force. The government doesn't grant us our freedom. The government serves us to ensure our freedom. We will be free either way. This is not a left versus right issue. This is a human rights issue. What you're supporting is inhumane and absent of love. Find that love and humanity within you, please. I know it's there. And I know you know deep down this is wrong.
Thank you, Mr. Zeck, and thank you for your service.
Thank you for listening to the National Association of Podcasters and oldgrads.com tutorial on informational tutorial. Hey, I'm trying to get these out fast with less editing. I would appreciate, though, if you would go ahead and subscribe and like these videos, and we'll get more up. They're real quick little trainers for both the NAOP and little messages for oldgrads.com. Hey, by the way, this week, go Army, beat Air Force.
Where are the Pattons? Where are the Eisenhowers? Where are the Bradleys? Where are the MacArthurs? Where are the Audie Murphys? They're all gone. We don't have any out there. I say, coming from a guy who's never been shot at in his entire life, that's a pretty bold statement. But you see, they were out there. And they are out there, and you will be out there. Because the Pattons and the Bradleys and the Audie Murphys and the Joe Clemens, they're not running around during peacetime killing people, I hope to hell. It takes a war to demonstrate that we have these people in our ranks. And our ranks are loaded with them. They are loaded with them. And you are going to be one of them when you join our ranks. And if there's any doubt in anybody's mind, or was any doubt in anybody's mind, there sure as hell isn't any doubt now, because it took us 100 hours to kick the ass of the fourth largest army in the world.